Here, but now what we have here, so what we are left with. geleden. Maar dan werd je de aan. Alles wat ik hier terug kan, voor jij ging weer dat was dat gas van probleem. Zo op deze gas van gezien, te gaan we dat bepoeien. En zo van wat ik zie, je ziet dat we pas ingegaan, maar het is palier. En dat is de maan op het palier. Maar ik heb de pannen van gezien gegaan, en wat ik eigenlijk zoek aan de terminal. Of voor dat is de maan van QE, de second order, aan de palier. Want hier is de terminal waar ik zeg, een issue, we zien de terminal dat het belang past. En de terminal dat de terminal past. Dus dat is de standaard gas integration formula. De volgende rol is de second neighbor en de terminal is in place. Alleen is dat de terminal fine, in the sense that if we know the field, so suppose we still have some of this six points, of course if we move in these directions, the function is still zero. And so we get a zero eigen value in this terminal, this is a Bosonic zero mode. So what we have to do when we have a Bosonic zero mode defined in the gas but we are moving zero mode, so we integrate on the zero mode. So this is what we do here. So this is our final expression. This is the expression of the path integral in the limit of its figure of infinity. But you see, since the real is not dependent on t, it is not an approximation, it's the exact value of the path integral at zero, which was our position. Path integral was computed. Now this is still a path integral. So have we gained anything? Well, we understand what this set of these points is. If it turns out that this set of these points is finite-dimensional, then we are on business because this path integral is not it is an isolated point, which affects the sum or the specific configuration, and we have to use the path integral to see it.
Can you answer the zero mode?
Yeah, so by definition, from here on the long zero mode of this function, the long zero mode of this function, so the long zero mode of the here, and the attribution which works out for the zero mode, is properly, either by inserting the operators, the concept terminals, the sensor, the zero mode, or the zero mode, to expand his action, so if you look at the terminal part of his action, the terminals, but because the anti-communals need to start expanding this concept for order, it's not anything this function, so you have to bring down the expanding action based on the first term, and they also cancel this.
Can there also be non-trivial interest from contributions in there?
Sorry?
Can there also be non-trivial interest from contributions in there?
Absolutely, yes. So we have to integrate all the special configurations from which this is true, but it's not necessarily for running configurations. This might be also the confermions are at term 1, and that is the case, so these are called fermions of us. The term on a fermion, but yet it's not increasing the energy or the action of this case. And generally, the idea is for running a fermion of us. In the example that we showed, it's not fermions of us, but it's an idea there too. Okay. In fact, it turns out that the space or configuration on which we localize are also DTI configurations. And one way to do that is the following. One way to do that is the following. So we can try to make a canonical choice for this B that we used before. So let's try to make the following choice for B, which is top one for all the fermions in the theory. We take the QA from psi, the afternoon from double dagger, psi, so this is double dagger, and double dagger is some anti-linear operator that we want to construct in such a way that delta BB is equal to zero. And in such a way that when we have the Q, so if we get the Bosonic part of this, what is this, the sum of the fermions of Q psi, double dagger Q psi, so there will be another term in which this is a double Q up from here, but it will be a fermionic action because it contains by CDD, so this is the Bosonic part. And if we can find some operator in this space of operative ideas, which is anti-linear, so it's like a dagger, it's not a field of key numbers, but we can choose whatever action we want on the field. If we find such an operator such that this is positive, and it preserves this property, then clearly follows that this set in which QV by Q equal to zero corresponds to the set Q psi equal to zero. But this set here is precisely the set of DTS configurations. So this is precisely the DTS, well, the DTS configuration is precisely what we pose. We set to zero the fermions, and we set to zero the variation of the fermions. So in fact, the path integral localizes on some set of DTS configurations. Alright, so this is the general formula, the general mechanism. Let me just make one comment, that the formula that we found, let me write it once again, our path integral becomes, the integral of the so-called classical action, such as the action evaluated on these configurations, divided by these superdeterminants, operator for Nightbot. This is what the schematic actions are. And of course, it's very clear that Nightbot doesn't know how to compute the flash stack, the boost spectrum of the flash operator and the cloud operator. However, we see, after all, we see a supersymmetry. We usually expect huge cancellations between bosonic modes and fermionic modes. And in fact, as we see in one example, these huge cancellations do take place. And in fact, one can reduce the composition of the superdeterminant, some cohomological problem, which can be solved, even though we are still not able to find the full spectrum of the Laplacian and the operator on the dipoles. So somehow this will be one hard part of the problem, but there are parts of the case to also compute it. One supercharge is enough. Of course, this is one argument. So first of all, you need one supercharge such that so first of all, you need to find this information that satisfies the this condition here. Moreover, you need to make sure. I mean, it depends on what the space of the configuration is. Now, this is one example. It might be harder or might be simpler. And you also need the identity from console in the space of complexity like this, where the reason of the integral is convergent. So also the formation since it's convergent. If that is not the case, you can still try to formally compute, but what you get in no sense. Okay. So now I would like to discuss one example. And I will not have time to finish this example, but let's try to set the stage. The second example I want to consider is an old example, a classic example, which is the 8th list of the nonlinear schema model. This is a new composition, but because of the first code, this was an appropriate thing to do, so this whole composition. And well, let's catch the point is an important point, but in particular, I would like to show what are the differences between the result of one can obtain with the old code list and then the result of one can obtain with the old code. So, my example is two dimensional n equals 2, nonlinear schema order. What a nonlinear schema model is, and then possibly come from there. So the nonlinear schema model is a few series of maps, phi, from the worksheet, which is our complex dimensional surface, to a target. In other words, the fields take value of some target manifold x. So this is two-dimensional quantum field theory. However, the fields live on some other manifold, which can have some generic dimension, let's call it degree. So this is what it is. However, we're interested in the first version of this theory. So in particular, we would like to consider the equal-to-quantum version of this theory. And, the nonlinear schema model consists of maps, of scalars. When we go to supersymmetric theory, we have to put these scalars into matrices. And for instance, what we can do is to put them into our matrices. This is not the only way to do that, but I want to consider this very simple case. And we can put them into chiral matrices of 0 and 1, and 0 times tensor charges. And if you decide to restrict this restricted class of example, then it turns out that we can preserve the amount of supersymmetry if x is a scalar manifold. In general, this will not be a super conformal theory, it will not be a supersymmetric theory. However, it turns out that this theory is conformal, it is a super conformal theory, if x is not a scalar, but it's a counterbounded trivial, and in particular, there are Reichert sets. Magic on the knife, what I asked you. Alright, so let's stop here and we will do a composition on the theory. Okay,
so if you only wanted to preserve n equals 1, so 31-1, then what would be the restriction on x? What would x have?
I'm sorry, is not the answer on order?
Yes.
So if your contractor set with 1, 1, n manifold is good. The only thing you have to do is you still have to put this boson into matrices. The 1, 1 matrix contains, so this is a complex boson. You put a Majorana fermion, which is 1, 1, and that's enough. And so, there are no restrictions on the manifold, so any manifold, which is 1, 1. So, these are also, yes, of course, I'm adding myself. I would like to clarify after the operation of the discussion session because I was not very clear. So the question was, we have this information of the action. So this here is a term, here we have a key, and then, well, we were expanding the key, so give you a calculation why we put the key minus one half, so like if we put a different power, the argument is different. And then it's because of the measure, because for the team's labs, these are the oscillations, oscillations around different populations. The team's labs is the dominant term. Now, we want to analyze the integral, but of course, the quadratic term is not diagonalized. And if we replace oscillation in this way, here in fact we have not normalized fields, and so the measure is not even a standard one. But of course, if we put a different factor here, then it will not be normalized, but the measure will modify. So essentially, the reason for it is because of the standard.